Yes, so you introduced that I'm from Deutsche Bahn. And you said, actually, well, that's an old-fashioned company we recognize, and I hope I can change that perception now. Since we have started to go into the data analytics, using data since now 2.5, a little bit more than that. I'm actually from DB Süssel, that's the IT service provider of Deutsche Bahn. They are actually hosting in the moment the data centers, all workplace, all different software developments and stuff like that. So we are hosting around 5 to 6 petabyte in the moment, which we also now migrating into the cloud. So one of that principle we learned this morning, actually we are already having in process. So we lift and shift all the different software stuff we have in the data centers, and actually we already sold them. So when DB Süssel recognized 3 years ago digitalization is coming along, they thought, well guys, we need to do something different, right? So far we had this hybrid delivery model, where we actually put stuff together for Deutsche Bahn, actually stuff which we took from vendors and then from other service providers, and we customized them for Deutsche Bahn. And so 3 years ago then, they said, well, for digitalization, we need to do something different. We work differently. And actually, that is also something what the guy said this morning in one of the principles. Hey guys, in the digitalization, we have to attract the employees much better and in a different way to actually join you, because there are actually not enough on the market as we in the moment recognize. And so DB Süssel actually said, let's start an internal corporate startup for the topic on big data. We are actually doing two less, and let's see whether we can actually speed up the process provide value for our internal customers by doing that. And so therefore, beside the existing business intelligence organization, they internally founded an internal corporate startup. At the beginning, we actually started with 5. And the process and how we have done it, actually, I will explain now to you in a minute. So the focus basically for these 5 guys starting was just big data. And find a business model and see whether you actually can make it within the group. They changed the processes around them, so they actually were really able to invest their money they have given by the company by themselves and see how actually they find the business. And so at the first, actually, we had to look where does it apply, right? Where in the company we can actually apply big data analytics topics, where can we find data, and how can we help our internal customers? And as you may recognize, we are a technology company besides the transport part. And so a lot of stuff is around assets and actually so things like predictive maintenance and things like that were kind of low-hanging fruits for us at the beginning to access the data. Then we had certainly the vision of this big data lake everybody is talking about, right? Now if you recognize Deutsche Bahn as a group has several hundreds of companies, independent companies. We are organized in a very federal way. So therefore, it was actually quite difficult, as also the guy said in the first presentation, to get all the data together, to find the data, right? So because it's they were very much distributed. And so what we said then, we need to find and have a a central place where we actually understand which data do we have. So we came up with this data portal, which was at the beginning just a website. In the meanwhile, we now introducing an information catalog, and we are for metadata and going for automatization on that data. So if data sources are changing, and the metadata is changing, then this information catalog is updated automatically, and that's very important for the data scientist for ad hoc analytics, so that they can find out which other data could be of interest for us to actually make a better meaning out of it. And then certainly for us, external data is very important, weather data, event data, which we actually providing to the company internally from the external market. And beside the data, certainly, we need to have, again, the analytics compute power. And that's basically what we do in the cloud or use in the cloud in the moment now. And providing that data, when we now come into the point where we actually provide it to other operation systems, then API was a very important topic. And so API first is something which we now introduce within the group between each other as well for actually exchanging data as well. So how did we start? Basically for us with five guys at the beginning, it was all about trust. You know, there are five guys coming fresh, they didn't have any references. So why should the internal customer actually work with you? And so we said, well, we need to introduce in a very agile way. We need to start with small proof of values and provide trust. And actually that every customer internally can understand how it feels, what can be out of big data analytics. Whether it's just that dashboard we just have seen, whether it's more advanced analytics results where they can apply it into their process, optimize their processes. So we came up with different t-shirt sizes and said, well, that's where we start. And basically, that starting point with a proof of values was very successful. So in the meanwhile, out of this proof of value projects we have done, 80% of them actually internal projects have started off for us. And so it was really kind of not wanting to build the final car in the end. It was really going step by step. And that is the important thing, actually. Think big, but start small. And that was very much an important part for actually our success so far. So then it's also about the organizational part. So starting with five people in an agile way, actually, well, that's easy, right? Yeah, you can have your daily, everybody's in sync, you have the same sprint cycle, and that's fine. Product owner is looking for business value, what you do. But then the first project came along, actually the first project is still our, in the meanwhile, largest project, because that's, in the moment, the digital situation room for the Deutsche Bahn Group, where actually all our CXOs and managers looking into actually and using that based on the different Deutsche Bahn KPIs all over the group apply then actions. So now for that first project, we needed to have a separate team because that was just focused on that team. And that changed the way of working for us very much, because now we had yeah, part of the team actually, which was just focused on that. And so we changed our work together. So we changed to having on the organization level a weekly, and within the team still having the daily. As I said, the proof of values were quite helpful, and so additional projects over time came up, and we actually had to grow our workforce, which was actually quite difficult as well. To find people internally which actually have that knowledge you need for the analytics side. As we had here this morning, yes, you can train people from business engineers which have that business understanding, but it takes time. And as a small team with your business case, you don't have so much time. And this is why we also need to employ new people into the team. And so what then appeared was we had a very good mix between internal people, external people, young ones. We even have one guy which is already 26 years with Deutsche Bahn. And so that was also, again, a success factor to have that good mix between the different experience, because it's not about only data science and data scientists. You also need to have the scrum master, the product owners, the architects, the guys which need about the platforms and so on. And so having a very good mix of competences is very important. It's not only about having a data scientist in a team. So the multiple competences are very important. And so each of these teams, actually, they just have one or two data scientists, and all the other guys are actually having other competences, like data engineers helping to introduce data and model the data, or business engineers to talk to the actually customer about the business part. Another important part, as it has shown in two slides ago, was then actually we were sitting together with our customers. We actually said this is a very important part for us, dear customer. We only can do it if we sit together, right? So if we actually at least have 50% of our project time access to your product owner on the business side, because the data scientists, they need to have this immediate feedback from the business whether they're going in the right way. And so all the agile way of working for that helped very much for that. So now, going forward, actually after 1.5 years, we now were more than 40 people, and the challenges were starting because we were kind of flexible teams up to that point. We always, when a new project came up, we kind of assigned new people to that, so we didn't have fixed teams, right? So it was very flexible in the organization. And that works, at least to our experience, up to around 40, 50 people. And then actually it's really getting a challenge to get that overview, to get the priorities right, and things like that. And so actually at that point, when we were mid last year, around 50 people, then we said now we have to go for a different organization internally. In the meanwhile, we had two larger customer teams because we had multiple projects already with one customer, where we needed several teams for that. And so we were thinking, how can we do it to go for that change? And in the meanwhile, certainly other requirements and influences were coming up in addition. So the portfolio actually was getting broader, right? So that's a challenge for that small team. We wanted to address more of the customers within the Deutsche Bank Group. And the business strategy, actually data strategy programs were coming up, which we needed to apply and so on. And for the delivery strategy, we had to move from the data center into the cloud. So we had to change stuff which we already have done. API first was coming up, and we wanted to deliver in a DevOps fashion too in these teams. So we also were thinking now to come up with a dedicated platform team to support the different analytics teams then. Also, together with the business strategy, what we have seen in the market, it was important to scale better internally also, that we don't do so much on the project side, so that we also come up and start to deliver as with services internally, right? So then the services which we actually can provide to multiple of our customers within the group. So that we actually can cope with the growth of the people business which we have if you only do projects. And the other challenge and influence which was coming up was then it was not only about doing analytics, statistic, description, or a little bit prediction on it, also real-time. The enterprise is getting more and more real-time now, right? So and now we also had to change models and actually how do we deliver internally. So stuff like real-time streaming and artificial intelligence is then an additional competence level for the guys. So we had to train people again and again and bring in other people as well. And if you have then a larger organization and move into fixed teams, which are again have different competence levels in that fixed teams, we were looking around how we can do it and how other people are doing that. You could come up with a scrum of scrums and agile scaled framework. And then we came across how actually Spotify is organizing themselves with actually their teams and their tribes being a unit for teams and then actually having guilds which are actually used to exchange information between each other, for example between the architects, so that we can secure that actually we still apply the same design principles for all these teams, which is very important for us in order to going forward or going forward and scale. And this is actually how we did it. We then came up with four unit segments. We clustered the large projects which we had at that time. For example, the Digital Situation Room, where we actually got the Bark Award for that now in the last challenge. As I said, that's about bringing all the KPIs together for the management in the group, starting with quality, being in time, and all this very important KPIs for us. And in the meanwhile, we have already 2,000 users for that in the management. Then we had other projects for the HR part, and actually that was about coming up with dashboards, but also with analytics capabilities. There we already have 9,000 users in the meanwhile. And on the data intelligence side, we were more clustering on the business domains because it's very important for the data scientists then to know about that business if they are already into that. And actually, I think that's what need to change here in Germany when we train data scientists as well, is that we introduce much more all the domain knowledge. And actually, the University of Berkeley are doing that. So in the second year, data scientists need to select a domain, a business domain, whether they go for biology or technology or whatever. But in addition to data science, they need to actually learn domain knowledge as well. And that's what we need as well, because that was something which we over these 2-3 years now had to do. As I said, services was very important too. So we came up internally now with video analytics service, with audio analytics service, with a smart booking service internally, and some more, which we kind of now run as a kind of spin-off teams. Because in the meanwhile, since this was working as a corporate startup, DB Systel came up with an all-over venturing and accelerator process, where we have 4 batches internally now a year, where teams can come up with ideas and form their internal startup, which we bring forward. And certainly, in addition, as I said, data ops, our platform as a service team, was important too. So how do we now work internally if we have this structure? So we actually have the product owner team on the portfolio level. And certainly, we have a board on that. But then we have on these units, which are clustering the teams, we also have our board. And then we also within the teams and in the projects, we have that too. And so as I said, very important for that, the communities are the communities where we share information across it. And that was also one of the principles which we have here this morning in the keynote. So train the people, that's very important. And we came up with, right from the beginning, that what we call Zeigen. That is actually a bi-weekly meeting where we show results to each other across the teams. That's very important for us as well, because that's not only knowledge sharing on a specific topic like architecture, but it's kind of cross domains or cross roles as well. And it's also a very good team building event for that as well. And so, summing it up for us, certainly we are in this digital transformation process, and everything is getting more agile. That's very important too. There are quite some challenges for that, as we also heard in the first presentation today. We should not underestimate that, what it really means, and that kind of change management, which we need to the company as well. It's a different culture, data thinking, to introduce that into the businesses, into the group in our case, is quite a long process. And you need to have quite some people for that. So our prediction now for mid of this year is actually that we have around 140 people then in the team within that 3 years. And beside actually all this data-driven analytics part and the challenge we had on that side, yes, there was quite a challenge on the organizational side too. Okay, so therefore, think big, but start small.
Thank you.